Good morning, everyone. Doc Stout coming back playing Invisible Ink. If you've been following my streams lately, you know I've been mostly doing card games, but I'm going to try something a little bit different today. I'm going to be doing Invisible Ink from Clay, who you may well know from the creators of Don't Starve, who was actually the first game I ever put up on YouTube. So we're going to go straight into the story mode. We're going to bypass the tutorial. We've got a couple of different options now. I've unlocked one extra... Oh, it looks like I've unlocked two extra options. But I'm going to start with a standard. Decker, the Stealth Master, and Internationale, the Hacker. I'm going to start with the standard Incognita programs. Incognita is the system you use for hacking various electronic devices.
Welcome back, Operator. Incognita is picking up some strange patterns in the global market. We don't know what it all means yet, but it's accelerating.
All right,
we should prepare
check out
for
targets.
A major action in the coming days. This won't be easy. Our resources
looks
are stretched thin.
Harsh.
I've lined up some lucrative contracts
Dubai,
and targets of opportunity that we can exploit to
there.
Better our position. I'll let you choose the
Anchorage?
Missions as you see fit, but be careful.
We
can't afford another
dispatch,
setback right
a
now.
Possibility. N10 Nanarivu. It's a vault. It's guarded or Brisbane in Australia. It's a detention center. Let's actually try the detention center. These are actually pretty hard for just a guarded level.
We've got them right where we want them. Look at the grid around this building. There is a detention facility
so,
on the ground.
There's a possibility
keep an
of a
eye
prisoner.
Open for
I might
agents.
Be able to pick up a third agent.
Grab as much as you can, but don't take any stupid
just
risks.
A
healthy agent is far more
individual.
Valuable than the contents of any safe.
All right, let's get started. You use action points. There's no, like, twitch reflex aspect to this game. As you go through turns, though, the alarm level gradually increases. Start with Deckard. You right-click to move around. We've got a door up here. He's got a few more action points than International. He doesn't have enough to look through the door, however. We'll move her up behind and reveal a couple more doors. We need to find the elevator, which is the exit, and get as much loot as we can on the way out. Power drip automatically gives one power at the start of each turn. Power is what's used to power the hacking. We currently don't see any devices that are hackable. Let's have Deckard peek through the door. Okay, that reveals a couple of hackable devices. We go into our hacking interface, console database, and a corporate safe. Let's hack them all. So that shows consoles where we can get more power, and we'll open the safe as well. Back out, we'll switch back to Deckard, have him open the door, and move to the safe. And we can loot it. Found $150. International will move up behind again, and from a distance, she can hack the console for extra power. Let's see if we have enough action points for Deckard to look through the next door. We do. Doesn't seem to be anything too interesting in there. Pass turn to get our action points back as the alarm level ticks up. Let's move Deckard to the other door and look through it. Alright, there's something going on in there. I can't tell. We can see that the enemy is watching those squares. I can't tell if that's because there's a guard there or if there's a camera. So we'll use International's special ability here, the wireless emitter, to detect any devices. Looks like we've got one. That's a power supply, probably for a turret. Let's open that door, though. Okay, the guard noticed the door open. He's going to be on his way towards us, but we can set ourselves on melee reaction, so both of us will try and hit him with a taser when he comes through. I'm actually not sure we're positioned optimally for that, but this might be a short first video. Oh, there we go. He's tased. He's down. I can also steal anything that's on him. He has 80 credits and a pass card. move up. Looks like there's a prisoner there. Let's have International hack the cell door. And then have Deckard step up and activate the console. Alright, he's got wealthy benefactors. This is not exactly what I wanted, but we got another person to deal with here. So he's pretty tired. He doesn't have very many action points. We just need to find a way out. We got some other doors back this way. The taser's only going to work for two turns, after which this guy's going to wake up. Oh, actually, he says he's down for six turns. That's cool. Maybe it's random. In any case, I don't want him waking up in this room, so we'll move Deckard here. Have him drag the body to this corner. And drop it here. And end the turn. Okay, cameras are up. Let's hack that camera, shut it down. Looks like I was seen by the camera. That's not gonna be good. So let's have Deckard. Let's get the prisoner to here. Have Deckard move through the door. Close it behind him so the guard won't immediately see where we are. Then hide here. Meanwhile, we'll have to set the International to melee reaction because we were seen by the camera, so this guard is on his way. Ah, there's a bunch of guards on their way. This is how I usually die. Alright. It appears that we're in bad shape here. He's seen the hostage, but Deckard has a special ability. He can use a cloaking rig. See if it's enough to get to one side of the guard. It is. I'm invisible. I can use my taser again. It's off cooldown. He's only down for two turns. We'll move International over to here. And move the guy we're trying to rescue up to here. This is a simple extraction job. We just need to find the exit. Okay, now all firewalls protecting electronic devices are upgraded. Looks like we've got two guards in the area. International's... Okay, that's one of the problems I have with this game occasionally, is it does not tell you...
Damn it, I've lost.
Where your movement path is gonna go. I thought I could move out and get to the side. So International's dead. This guy saw her, put himself on Overwatch, and I thought I was gonna go around this way, but instead I just walked and he just shot her in the head. Alright. Let's see if we can get out, though. At this point, I'm guessing no.
Hey! Investigate!
I got two turns left on my taser's cooldown. And seven turns left on the modded cloaking rig. And... like a fool, I just walked the prisoner out and got him shot. All right, I am not doing so hot.
Investigate right down.
I'm not even gonna take the time to peek. I'm just gonna move. Something can see in here, but I don't have any time to worry about that right now. Yeah, I have no idea what's looking at this door. I can't see a camera. There's the camera. Alright, at least I can hack the camera. See if I can at least escape with my life. So I've lost the target, lost an agent, and we're just trying to get Deckard out with his hide intact. That's an elevator through which they are going to bring reinforcements. No good for me. Alarm level is steadily crawling up.
Checking it out. Investigating area. Investigating area.
Peek through. I can see a camera through there. Let's not alert them to my presence just yet. There's also a guard in there. My taser's off cooldown, so I can set myself to react to this guy. And then turn. Maybe I can actually get out of here. As the other guards are frantically searching for Deckard. Why not rob this guy, see if we can get something out of it. I need to peek at this point. It's unfortunate that I do not have the international, because I really need to be able to see. The camera's probably over in this corner where I can't see it. Alright, now the guard patrols are going to come out of that elevator. Now we'll hack the camera at least. And peek through the next door. Where we can at least see the camera this time. And I'm out of power. Choice. Uh-oh, I don't actually see an exit out of that way. Uh-oh. Where could the exit be? Oh, there it is. Looks like we escaped. Sure, I want to leave Internationale behind, but she's dead, and I don't have any way to revive her. So, the after-mission report. Deckard is active. I explored 78% of the map. I didn't get any corporate intelligence. I got 910 credits, including the 500 I started with. And Internationale is MIA. The after-mission report, you can use your available currency to increase your skills. Stealth lets you move further. Hacking makes you better at hacking the various systems. Inventory lets you carry more, and anarchy makes you better at stealing. That's some basics. As you can see, I'm not very good at the game yet. I think I'm going to call this introductory video right here. Thanks for tuning in. This is Doc Stout. This was Invisible Ink.